from Parliament, power distributor Umeme and Uganda Police Force have nated 100 people in Jinja during an operation against illegal power connections. The operation targeted Bugembe Town Council, where 90% of the power users had illegal connections. Residents in the area are now worried that with the darkness, they are at the verge of being targeted by thieves. We have this story.
The operation, dubbed Combo, was started by a briefing to officers, both from the police and Umeme, at the Umeme Jinja office. Officers were first to reach Bugembe, the target area, before the culprits could be alerted. On seeing men in uniform, people with illegal connections started taking off, abandoning their businesses.
That's it from this one. Even this one.
Which one?
Darawis Matovu, an illegal operator locally known as Kamiufu, was one of those apprehended. He was found in possession of Umeme properties that included uniforms, meters, yaka cards, circuit breakers, among others. Allegedly, Matovu is part of the racket that steals meters and circuit breakers and also operates illegal connections in the eastern part of the country. Other suspects had looped wires to the grid directly without meters, and many were business people operating retail shops, among other small-scale businesses. Residents, however, scoffed at the power distributor and the police for not alerting them prior to the operation. They also advised Umeme management to first clean their house before carrying out such operations. They accused Umeme employees as perpetrators of illegal connections in exchange for small sums of money from the locals. They further advised government to reduce on the tariffs on electricity such that it's affordable to everyone. The operation left Bugembe Town Council in total darkness, putting residents into fear of being robbed by thieves. John Wamanya from Umeme says that Jinja is one of the areas that have high cases of power theft in the country. He, however, implored everyone to report illegal power connections to either Umeme or the police.
Yep. When you combine the Kampala districts and Jinja, just from between Jan and March, we have already lost 60 billion shillings to power theft, with Jinja inclusive. 60 billion Uganda shillings. What that money could have done was, because these people who steal power do not pay taxes, the taxes against that amount which was paid would have built for people roads, would have built hospitals, would have provided services. We are also encouraging the public, especially our residents within Jinja, where we are here, when you see something, say something.
The operations commander warned people in eastern Uganda who have illegally connected to the grid to disconnect or face being apprehended.
Because we are determined, then the last word of N is non-discrimination. It is what the RPC was saying, that targeting now, when you are called Nabulime and Namusoke, is the other side, you want to go there so that you will aid Namusoke to escape. No, that was non-discrimination. Law must be applied equally. Yes, all people must what? Must be handled equally.
Story compiled by Ivan Lubega for the news in Jinja City.